and the players getting themselves into game mode with the tip-off just moments away. Welcome, everyone. Thanks for tuning in to 2K Sports for this NBA presentation. Kevin Harlan here along with Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony. And now a quick check of our starting lineups for both teams. Okay, first for the Bulls. Michael Carter-Williams is out there with Dwayne Wade. And playing at the center position, one of the Lopez twins out of Stanford, 7-foot banger Robin Lopez. Then there's Jimmy Butler. And it's Gibson in at the four. And for the Timberwolves, Ricky Rubio is out there with LaVine. They've got Towns. No doubt one of the premier big men in the league, a superstar talent all the way around. Then it's Andrew Wiggins, and it's Jang in at the four. Off goes to Minnesota. Now here's Rubio. Wiggins passes to LaVine. Rubio right side. Just five on the clock. The feed to LaVine. Goes up from the top of the key. And the rebound goes to Lopez. Minnesota on D. Carter Williams with it. Butler on the wing. He passes to Lopez. The shot's good on the assist by Butler. Lopez has got the first points up on the board here for Chicago. Earlier, Doris Burke spoke with head coach Fred Hoiberg. What did you find out, DB?
We talked about the challenges posed by a player like Ricky Rubio, such a tremendous passer and floor general. Coach said, we know he can make plays, but making shots is where he's been less effective. We need to focus on staying home and forcing him to beat us with his scoring. Guys, we'll see if they can limit his highlight reel dimes. Back to you.
And thanks for that story, Doris. Now, here's Wade. From 17 feet out and off the glass. That one's good.
And there's something else on his resume that can't be overlooked. Just how many times he's taken over at the end of close games and carried his team to the win.
Carter Williams against Rubio. Back to Wiggins. He dishes it to Jang. Can't get it to go. Great D that time from Gibson. And Chicago has possession. And it's stolen by Ricky Rubio. Fast break, Minnesota. Rubio's got the ball. LaVine.
And he doesn't really matter who starts the break with how he runs the floor. He seems to always be the one who finishes.
Yeah, he is so fun to watch and how he attacks the rim at full speed like that, man. It's something to behold the way that guy gets to the rim.
Lopez sets a screen for Wade. Wade, right side, pocket six. And it's Gibson, that time on the assist by Wade.
And you're going to take as many of those high percentage shots as you can get.
Timberwolves have gone 2 for 4 from the field so far today. They set the pick. Kicks to Wiggins. Got it from 16 feet.
Whatever their plan was defensively that time, it didn't work. Not if it results in that shot.
For Chicago, they've gotten their first three shots to go in for to start off this game. Wade drives in. He kicks it to Lopez. And a missed layup.
And that's just great work there to get in the shooter's space and then go and corral that backboard.
Rubio with a screen on Carter Williams. Here's LaVine. Sinks the triple. LaVine's got five now.
The screenplay worked ideally there, and I'm not talking about the screenplay you see in a movie theater. Gave him more than enough room to get that shot off.
Now, here's Wade. Pass to Carter Williams. And they're going to count the bucket and send him to the line. It could be a three-point play.
Well, that's one way he can finish, but far from the only way he gets it done. He's got all kinds of tricks up his sleeve.
Chicago shooting their first foul shot of the game.
And last season, as a team, they knocked down 79% of their free throws, so those are numbers you'll be happy with.
And you know, a lot of times, guys, in some of their performances last year, their free throw numbers helped them win games.
Now, here's Rubio. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Here's Towns. And the Timberwolves tack on two more. And here's Wade. Pass to Carter Williams. They double him with Wiggins. Outside for Carter Williams. Back to Wade. Six on the shot clock. And Zach LaVine gets the whistle that time. That is his first foul of the game. Lopez outside, back to Gibson, six to shoot, vicious to Wade, and it's good with time running down on the shot clock.
And he's not going to pass up on chances like that, even with just a sliver of daylight, he can get to the rim.
And Rubio kicks to Wiggins. Feeds it to LaVine. A putback cleans up the mess with the savage putback flush.
Well, I love that aggression. Forget about the tip. Just grab the thing and slam it home.
Well, what a way to get second chance points.
And don't take any risk while you're doing it.
The pass to Gibson. Outside Butler. And it's Chicago scoring again.
Well, I tell you what, I need to see some more assertiveness out of these defenders. They're not getting the job done.
That's a great point. 10 of the last 12 points they've allowed have come at the rim.
So the Timberwolves call their first timeout. Timberwolves have gone 6 of 9, shooting well. LaVine dishes to Wiggins. Wiggins right side. And it's blocked by Wade. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Bulls will take it. Mirotić has checked in for Robin Lopez. Here's Carter Williams. Outside Butler. He feeds it to Wade. Fader on the way. Shot is no good. And it's the Timberwolves taking it the other way. Here's LaVine, covered by Mirotić. Rubio outside. Shot clock at 6. Butler against Wiggins. That misses off the backboard. Here's Carter Williams. Mirotić sets the screen for Carter Williams. Passes it to Mirotić. Back to Carter Williams. The dish to Mirotić. On the top of the key. Good, he hits the jump shot. The Timberwolves trail. Here's LaVine. 5 points in the game. The feed now to Rubio. He passes to LaVine. That's good. It's Rubio with the assist. LaVine. Levine's got 8 points.
Really hard to find fault with anything he's doing this quarter, at least at the offensive end.
Wade passes to Mirotić. Carter Williams. Good ball movement here by the Bulls. Butler gets to Carter Williams. He dishes it to Wade. Wade, right side. Towns with the steal. Here's Levine, covered by Mirotić.
Rubio.
Towns kicks to Wiggins. Pass to Towns. Mirotić is there. And the bucket counts, and he's on his way to the free throw line. Try to make it a three-point play.
I love how he establishes his post position inside before he converts.
Some changes for Chicago. Portis is checked in for Gibson. Doug McDermott comes in for Jimmy Butler. And it's Isaiah Cannon in for Dwayne Wade. Here's Cannon. Grant outside. Kicks it to Cannon. Pass to Mirotić. He kicks it to Cannon. Four on the clock. Puts it up from 17, but he recovers it. Whoops, there's the 24-second shot clock violation, so they'll turn it over. Cole Aldridge is checked in for the Timberwolves. Timberwolves leading by four. There's a good screen. Dishes to Muhammad. And the pass to Dunn. Six to shoot. The jumper from the free throw line is good. And the Timberwolves lead by six.
And their offense already in a flow. Some stellar shooting to jump out to this lead.
Quality looks they're getting, and they're capitalizing on them, guys. They have to be happy with this start offense.
Now, here's Grant. Cannon kicks to Grant. They need this. Count that one. Grant's got his first points in this one.
The entire defense was frozen foot. Nobody picked up the shooter, Kevin.
Dunn passes to Muhammad.
Right there!
106 left to play in the first quarter. Dunn. Shoots from the line. And there are the Timberwolves with another bucket. Now Grant. Feeds it to Mirotić. Passes it to McDermott. Back to Mirotić. Jacks up a three. Rush grabs the miss.
You know, even though he missed that one, great shooters have a way of feeling when they've got enough room to pull the trigger.
No doubt about it. The defense, you can see him exhaling right now. Fortunate that he didn't knock that one down.
Muhammad, the pass to Dunn. Here's Bielitsa. Six on the shot clock. Let's it go from deep. Now here's Muhammad. He hasn't scored yet. That I'm sure will change. Dunn passes to Bielitsa. Drops in the layup for two.
And every once in a while, he'll show up and give you some great moves around the hoop.
No luck. And that does it for the first quarter. Timberwolves lead by eight. And don't go away. We'll be back momentarily. And now the second quarter just getting set to start. And what do you guys think about Minnesota here in this one?
It's been about the effort. Love the hustle they've shown here in the first.
Yeah, it's due to their hustle, as you said, Greg, and it's showing up on the scoreboard, too.
Here's Cannon. Here's Grant. Hands it from downtown. Grant's got the first points up on the board here in the second quarter for the Bulls. Here's Dunn. He's covered by Grant. Muhammad with it. He passes to Dunn. And it's blocked. Here's Cannon. He feeds it to McDermott. Another three for Chicago.
That's two straight quick three-pointers they've allowed.
Defense just not reacting with enough aggressiveness.
Kick it out, kick it out.
And Bialica kicks to Muhammad. Back and down. Pass to Bialica. There's the dish to Muhammad. There's the feed to Aldridge. The Timberwolves need to get a shot off here. Dunn misses.
Boy, there was no hand in his face right there. I thought for sure he was going to knock that down.
And we're a little over a minute and a half into the second quarter of action. Mirotić. And the Bulls, another three.
A lot of space right there to get that shot off.
Not a very good job of the defender getting over the top of that screen in that particular play.
Minnesota calls timeout.
And look, rightfully disappointed with how they played here over the course of this run.
Yeah, you know, they haven't looked good at all here lately. Something has to change for them, and we'll see what he's got coming out of the timeout.
Robin Lopez is checked in for the Bulls. Here's Dunn. He dishes it to Muhammad. Pass to Dunn. Kicks to Rush. There's the pass to Dunn. Puts up the baby hook. But they get it back.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. Five buckets in a row from the paint.
And on the flip side, Greg, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior. They've got to offer more resistance here.
Grant in the post. He kicks to Lopez. Dishes it to Mirotić. Fires for three. Minnesota with the rebound. Second quarter of play with almost 3 minutes gone. Chang, a screen.
Help out, help out.
Here's Dunn.
Yo, yo,
back to Chang. Mirotić grabs the miss.
Ill-advised dunk attempt there. He aimed for the highlight reel and ended up on the blooper reel.
Grant dishes to McDermott. Grant, Bulls moving the ball around. Cannon kicks to Mirotić. Drains it from beyond the arc. Mirotić just got 8 points.
Great outside shooting fueling this run.
And the D is getting bombarded. They haven't been able to slow them down the least bit.
Here's Rush. Here in the second quarter, just under 3.5 minutes played. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Bulls will take
it. You know, that's hard to explain that play. I mean, I guess he thought he had more room than he did.
Some changes for Chicago. Taj Gibson's checked in for Mirotić. Jimmy Butler comes in for Doug McDermott. And Dwayne Wade subbed in for Isaiah Cannon. Now here's Carter Williams. Wade sets the pick for Carter Williams. Butler kicks to Carter Williams. The kick outside to Butler. Lays it up, and despite of the excellent defense at that, and the Bulls lead by 4. Timberwolves have gotten off to a rough start here in the second quarter, going just 1 for 5. Rubio with a screen on Wade. Levine kicks to Wiggins. Pass to Bialica. Leaps for it, and out of bounds as Chicago gains possession. Towns is checked in for Bialica.
Carl Anthony Towns.
And so here is Chicago. Only given up 2 points this quarter. Carter Williams, the pass to Lopez. Good. Now it's a 6-point Chicago lead.
They have repeatedly probed inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid dividends.
And with as many points as they've got in the paint, you know, they haven't had to do much work on the perimeter.
Now here's Jang. That is good. Chicago leading by four. And here's Wade. Feeds it to Carter Williams. Lock at six. Wade drives in. Goes up at the stripe. Can't get it to go. So Minnesota will take it the other way. Rubio dishes to Wiggins. That's in. Coming off an assist from Rubio. Rubio's got three assists now in this one. Back to Butler.
Wait.
He passes it to Carter Williams. Right side, Butler. And he uses the glass on the layup. Butler's got 4 points in the quarter.
Huge hole in the defense that possession. He didn't waste any time cutting through it.
Rubio with it. Now guarded by Gibson. Levine kicks to Zhang. Lopez is there. Fades away. And the rebound goes to Lopez. Lopez has got his fourth rebound in this one. Rubio against Carter Williams. Wade, right side. Another one falls for Chicago. Timberwolves trail by six. Rubio outside. Kicks it out to Wiggins. And you can count it. He'll go to the line with a chance to make it three.
Yeah, terrific play right there. Great strength to finish through the contact.
That's exactly how it should be done. Get the bump, concentrate on the shot, and you'll get the bucket too.
The free throw drops for Towns. So it's Chicago now. Wade outside. Lopez sets a screen for Wade. Six on the shot clock. Rebound, Minnesota.
And that's the shot he has to take.
Exactly. That's the right look. The decision was good. He just didn't execute.
I'm a fan of anybody who defends that way. I mean, they weren't about to open the door and just allow him to cruise in for a layup.
Lopez from 13. That falls. Nice feed that time from Dwayne Wade. Lopez has got 4 points now in the quarter. Timberwolves trail by five. Here's Levine. He's got eight. Towns, the best to Dang. Now Carter Williams.
Wait.
Wade outside. He feeds it to Gibson. Back to Wade. And it's stolen by Ricky Rubio. Higgins outside. Towns sets the pick for Wiggins. Back to Rubio. Pass to Levine. Six to shoot. And he gets it to go. Levine's got 10.
Nice job creating for the easy deuce.
Chicago leading by three. And the first timeout of the game called for Chicago. Change here. Portis is checked in. Rubio against Carter Williams. Now the dish to Wade. Carter Williams. Pass to Portis. Left side, Butler. Five on the clock. From deep. And that is good. Butler's got nine.
And that's what you like to see from a competitor. Really able to just shake off that poor first quarter and focus on the here and now.
Minnesota calls timeout. Ten left in the first half of basketball. Levine dishes to Jang. That's good. Jang's got four this quarter.
The plan of attack is obvious. Get the ball inside and go strong to the rim.
And Greg, you know, the defense has been very slow to adapt. I mean, that's 10 straight points now inside.
The drive by Wade. And he gets it to go. Wade's got 8 points.
He shot the ball exceptionally well as they've built this lead for themselves here.
A chance at a 2-for-1 if they want it.
If I'm them, I try it.
Rubio with it. Now defended by Carter Williams. And the jam by Levine.
Incredible timing on the alley-oop.
He absolutely hammered it down.
And guys, mark that play right there because that could be the one that leads to a surge to break this thing wide open.
Carter Williams. And the Bulls tack on two more. Timberwolves trail by 6. Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. And Zhang kicks to Rubio. The feet to Wiggins. Back to Rubio. Shot clock at 6. Shot from 12. Cannot hit.
Well, I think he had all the space he needed. He just couldn't find the bottom of the net.
And that concludes the first half. It's the Bulls leading by 6. And we'll be back for the second half following the break. Keep it right here on 2K Sports. Welcome back, everybody. The start of the second half getting underway. Both teams battling hard through the first half. You look at Zach LaVine, he's really been playing well.
And he just went off in those first two quarters, guys. He's capable of doing that on a consistent basis as well. So we might see some changes from a defensive standpoint as they try to disrupt his rhythm in the second half.
You know, guys, I think you've got to make some sort of change. I mean, they can't let him continue to torch him up like he has been.
Chicago shooting their second and third free throws tonight. That free throw, no good. And he sinks the second. Timberwolves trail by 7. Now, here's Rubio. Quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. Here's Wiggins. Here's LaVine. Count the buckets.
Just no resistance on the inside. That's their 5th consecutive make in the paint.
And Greg, those looks they're allowing are almost automatic.
Wade kicks to Carter Williams. They double him with Wiggins. To Carter Williams. He dishes it to Butler. Kicks it to Gibson. The shot's good on the assist by Butler. Gibson's got his 2nd basket of the game.
Oh, terrific way to finish that move there, going to the basket.
Towns sets the pick for Rubio. Rubio left side. The pass to LaVine. Lock at 6. He kicks it to Wiggins. Lets it fly. And good as it just snugs right down through the net. over a minute and a half into the third quarter of action. Wade with it. He's got eight. And out of bounds as the Timberwolves gain possession. Here's Rubio. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. And we're just around 2 minutes into the final half of play now. Wiggins kicks to Rubio. There's Levine. No good on the triple.
You know, 9 times out of 10, he's going to knock that one down. He'll spray that one on you.
Lopez sets a screen for Carter Williams. He's made 2 of his 3 attempted tonight. First one falls for him. Williams hits them both. Timberwolves trail by 7. Levine kicks to Towns. Dishes it to Levine. Offline with his 3.
Boy, but he was close, Kevin, to making the defense pay for lackadaisical coverage there.
Yeah, you may not be as lucky next time down if you're the defense. We cannot allow him to get those kinds of looks.
Gibson passes to Butler. Gibson dishes to Butler. And he gets it to go. Butler's got 11 points. So it's Minnesota now. 9-point game. Clark, they've been looking out of sync offensively.
You know what? A basket here would do a lot for their confidence.
And Rubio kicks to Wiggins. Passes it to Levine. 6 on the shot clock. And a Jang. Stolen by Wade. Here's Carter Williams. And that one's good. And it's an 11-point Chicago lead.
Up and in on every one of their first 3 shots to start the second half.
Minnesota calls timeout.
Just not happy with how his team is playing, and they just have been on the wrong side of this run.
Yeah, and you know what, Greg? Sometimes just a pause in the action, which is what a timeout can give you, is enough to change things around.
The Bulls making a switch here. Third quarter action in just under 3.5 minutes have gone. Here's the screen. Wade brings the double team. Rubio the pass to Levine. That's in, coming off an assist from Rubio. Levine's got 5 points now in the quarter. The Bulls leading by 8. Mirotić, a screen on Rubio. Carter Williams kicks to Butler. To Carter Williams. Feeds to Mirotić. Shot clock at 5. Fade away. It's Chicago with another bucket.
They are on fire right now. That's 4 straight makes.
And here's Rubio. Looking for his first basket still in this one. He feeds it to Levine. Shoots the 3, and another 3 for Minnesota.
And with that 3, his 2nd of the half, he's equaled his total from before the break.
Wade kicks to Butler. Carter Williams. And some nice ball movement here by Chicago. Mirotić dishes to Butler. Pass to Levine. Plays it up and banks it in. And now just a 5-point Bulls lead.
And he's clearly led the way offensively. The question is, can they ride him and get back into it?
Carter Williams, the pass to Wade. Wade, right side. Here's Lopez. And he was fouled in the act of shooting. Chance here now for a 3-point play.
That was a smart pass by Wade that time.
And a moment to look at the scoring approach in terms of where the points are coming from for the Bulls.
From mid-range, it's been a very nice game for them. I mean, they've been finding the bottom of the net a lot.
Yeah, and it doesn't hurt to be on fire from beyond. They have been really good from the three-point line.
Here's what Chicago's going with right now. Doug McDermott, he's checked in for Jimmy Butler. And it's Isaiah Cannon in for Dwayne Wade. Rush outside. Mirotić grabs the miss. The Bulls leading by 8. Here's Cannon. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him. Lopez a screen. Brent kicks to Cannon. It's good from long range. And the Bulls lead by 11.
And that's going to increase the field goal percentage even more. They are at a huge edge in that category.
And that's because they've been playing smart basketball. I mean, they've been very patient offensively, and their shot selection has been superb.
Dunn passes to Aldridge. Stolen by Grant. Oh, and a fast break for the Bulls. Grant leading the charge, and Cannon gets it to go.
And I like how he puts himself in position there to finish on the break.
Yeah, you know, that's what we call seeing and feeling the game. Excellent read of how that play was going to develop and where the ball was going. That's stuff that you oftentimes can't teach, Greg.
The dish to Mirotić, 6 to shoot, and the Bulls tack on 2 more.
This is crazy. Every shot they're taking right now is finding the mark.
Literally every shot, partner. I mean, they just aren't missing.
Dunn passes to Aldridge. And there's the feed to Rush. Wide open look. Chicago grabs the miss. Cannon's got his 3rd rebound tonight. Pass to Mirotić. Launches a 3. That is good. Mirotić has got 7 now in this quarter.
You know, it's really hard not to notice the difference in the passing of these two teams today.
Yeah, it's a stark discrepancy when you look at the assist columns and you see that difference as far as the fluidity in their respective offenses.
And there's the pass to Dunn. He passes to Muhammad. His 1st shot coming late. No good on the shot. A bit long that time.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Yeah, you look across the board, it's actually sizing up, shaping up to be a great game. I mean, strong performances throughout, and they've really been strong on the glass.
Timberwolves trail by 16. Passes to Dunn. Rush takes a 3. Mirotić grabs the miss. Mirotić has got his 3rd rebound tonight. McDermott dishes to Cannon. And good on the basket. Book it. Cannon's got 7 points.
Nice pass. He got the ball right into his teammate's shooting pocket. On time and on target.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've had a number of empty ones, a long time without a basket.
I got to find something, you're right. Kicks it to Rush. Pass to Dunn. 5 to shoot. To stop the drought.
That's good.
He has 6. 106 left in the 3rd. Grant kicks to Cannon. Back to Grant. He dishes it to Cannon. Off the mark there with the 3-point shot.
He certainly didn't take advantage of the poor defense, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
I tell you what, I think he'd be happy if he can continue to get looks like that.
Rush the pass to Bialica. Lopez with the block. Mirotić dishes to Grant. Back to Mirotić. Rush with the steal. 2 seconds separating the shot clock and game. He kicks to Aldridge. Pass to Bjelica. And stolen by Mirotić. Here's Cannon. 7 points in the game. And Mirotić kicks to Grant. 1 second left. Mirotić gets the bucket. Mirotić has got 9 points here in the second half.
And he's really made the most of his opportunities today. I mean, he needs to keep working for those kinds of looks.
Well, through three quarters of play, down double digits, it may be difficult to overcome. And thanks again for joining us. Let's see what happens here in the fourth. Timberwolves trail by 18. Here's Dunn. Wiggins, right side. Gives him the lead pass.
No question, he got bumped on that shot.
Yeah, the officials didn't need to talk that one over. It was obvious.
Shooting for Minnesota, Nemanja Bjelica.
And the first one at the line is good. Off on that one, so he goes 1 for 2 at the line.
The edge on the glass is the difference. It's allowed them to build this lead.
And really a reflection of their superior effort level to this point. It seems to me they've gone after this win a little bit more.
6 on the shot clock. 13 feet away. And the shot is good. And that's 12 points for Michael Carter-Williams. Minnesota's gotten fewer than half of their three-pointers to go down tonight. They're 4 for 9. 1 minute now into this fourth quarter. Now the pass to Dunn. A stupendous finish in traffic. The Bulls leading by 17. Dishes it to Cannon. Feeds to McDermott. Passes it to Cannon. Launches it. Can't get it to go. And it's the Timberwolves taking it the other way. Here's Dunn. Carter Williams covering. Dunn passes to Wiggins. Gets it to go from beyond the arc.
That was simply a defensive breakdown there, Kevin. He was all alone for that shot. It was a warm-up jumper.
Here's Cannon. Muhammad covering. Here's the screen. He feeds it to Mirotić. It's hauled in by Dunn. Timberwolves trail by 14. The dish to Wiggins. Towns sets the pick for Wiggins. Now the feed to Muhammad. Kept alive, Minnesota. Here's Bjelica, covered by Mirotić. And they finally get it to go. A full night's work on the boards in one trip down the floor.
He was the first one to react to that miss. Excellent anticipation on his part. A hustle play on the putback by him.
Time called here. The Bulls decide to talk it over.
And really just trying to take the wind out of their sails here, I think. You know, they're on the wrong end of a run and need to just kind of exhale.
Yeah, sometimes you just need to stop the bleeding. Things were starting to spiral completely out of control. I think a timeout was a no-brainer there.
Let's go quickly over to Doris Burke for an update.
Well, Kevin, I was able to listen in on what the head coach of the Chicago Bulls was going over in his huddle. He wants them to pick it up and really go for it right now, saying, no time like the present, gentlemen. Embrace it. Embrace the spotlight and let's make it happen. Kevin, let's see what they can do.
Just 5 to shoot. Here's Carter Williams, and he hits the jump shot. Carter Williams has got 4 points now in the quarter. Timberwolves trail by 14. Rubio outside. Higgins outside. 14 feet away.
Put it back, put it back.
Here's Dang. It's hauled in by the Bulls.
Oh, tough D on the inside.
It sure was, Greg. No easy access to the basket when that fella's in the middle.
Mirotić dishes to Wade. The Bulls need to get a shot off here. Mirotić's shot is off.
He's been trying to add that mid-range to his arsenal, but it still isn't there just yet.
And Rubio kicks to Levine. Back to Rubio. Mirotić brings the double team. And the basket by Rubio. Now Wade. Kicks it to Carter Williams. Mirotić sets the screen for Carter Williams. He passes to Mirotić. Wade, Jang defending. Wade against Jang. Here's Mirotić. That falls. Nice feed that time from Dwayne Wade. And that's now 20 points for Nikola Mirotić. Now, here's Rubio. Wiggins, right side. Pass to Dang. Good on the 13-footer.
Yeah, that's asking a lot from that defender.
Yeah, it certainly is. I mean, he just doesn't have the size to really be effective in that kind of matchup.
Wade outside. Mirotić sets the screen for Wade. He dishes it to Mirotić. He kicks it to Carter Williams. Fade. Another three for Chicago.
He's a big reason why they have the lead right now. He's made all of his field goal attempts thus far and remains hot from the floor.
Here's Levine. Wade is covered. Wiggins drives in. That's good. The Bulls leading by 13. Carter Williams with it. Just to Wade. Oh, and that one, no question, powered it down.
Ooh, that's as forceful a finish as you're ever going to see out of this guy.
Well, gee, it adds now to their lead in spectacular fashion.
And, you know, that lead's only going to grow if they're not prepared to defend a little more staunchly than that.
And he caps off the fast break with a monster slam.
And, guys, that's a big swing right there. I mean, taking the steal and then turning it into two easy points on the dunk.
No telling how important that sequence could turn out to be.
And, guys, in a game this snow, moments like that are the ones we usually look back on at the end as a difference maker.
Robin Lopez is checked in for Chicago. Gibson comes in for Mirotić. Here's Levine. Misses the three. Oh, Chicago has gone 2-3 in the fourth quarter from long range. Good shooting so far. Carter Williams, the pass to Lopez. No good. So Minnesota will take it the other way. Wiggins against Butler. Here's Levine. Rubio with a screen on Wade. There's the pick. Shot clock at 6. Wiggins drives in. And it's Chicago with the rebound. Lopez has got his 5th rebound in this one. The pass to Gibson. And it's stolen by Ricky Rubio. Levine dishes to Wiggins. Into Jang. And that one's good.
And he's really shot the ball well, but it hasn't been contagious.
Chicago leading by 15. And here's Wade. And it's stolen by Ricky Rubio. .153 left in the fourth quarter. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two.
Yeah, how about the body control on that one? Narrowly misses getting the deuce.
Boy, he had a nice look at it after drawing the foul. Boy, it would have been nice to get an and one there.
He hits both from the stripe. For Chicago, they've gotten into a pretty good groove, going 6-10 here in the final quarter. Rubio against Carter Williams. Dishes to Wade. Back to Carter Williams. The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way. That'll put Michael Carter Williams on the line. Ricky Rubio picks one up.
They're drawing more whistles and working their way to the line here in the second half.
And guys, I think it's exactly the right thing to do with the lead. Keep going at defenders and find a way to get yourself to the line.
Minnesota calls timeout. They're down by 16. 1:36 left here in the fourth quarter. Wiggins kicks to Rubio. Back to Wiggins. Wiggins right side. Down to five on the shot clock. Feeds it to Jang. Good! .114 left in the fourth quarter of this one. Guys, a good chance for them to slow it down.
Yeah, I agree. Got to use some clock here.
See you on my way.
Rubio against Carter Williams.
Butler. D-Wade.
Backs him down. Five to shoot. Goes up the baseline. Here's Lopez. And that one is good with the extra effort on the glass. And the Bulls lead by 16.
And he really is a tough guy to go up against because he throws his weight around so often and with reckless abandon. I mean, it can really wear you down physically.
Rubio with it. Now defended by Carter Williams. And Rubio kicks to Wiggins. Back to Rubio. Levine. That's good. It's Rubio with the assist.
You cannot leave him alone like that, especially from long range.
We've got 33 seconds left in the fourth quarter. For Chicago, they've gone 8 of 13 from the field since the start of the fourth, sinking the majority of their shots. Rubio against Carter Williams. Clock at 6. Now here's Butler. He's covered closely. And it's Chicago scoring again.
Well, if it wasn't out of reach, it is now, thanks to that last little spurt.
And why put the brakes on now? I just say keep on letting it fly.
Here's Levine. Misses the shot. And so Chicago takes this one, and by a big margin. A solid win on the road for them. This building was dead silent by the time GA this one wound down.
And that's what you want to do. Take the crowd out of it by crunch time. Don't give them any chance to lift their team up at the finish.
Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony, this is Kevin Harlan along with our 2K Sports crew, thanking you for tuning in.